Hello, Dissenters. Today we're back in Transport Fever, but this is not the campaign. This is the Freeplay mode. You spawn a brand new map, either in Europe or America, with a random seed, and it creates different environments, different terrain, different hills, mountains, rivers, oceans, city locations, and products as produced by these various facilities. Some for things like wood. For example, over in this corner, where we have some loggers. Some maybe iron to be turned into tools. The list goes on, and some are very complex. Like this facility here. Armskirk Machine Factory requires a load of planks, steel, and plastic to make machines and tools. But all of these ways are methods that you might be able to make money by creating good systems of either track or road, or perhaps airports or ports for boats, to get all those resources where they need to go and make a ton of money. It's a little daunting, isn't it? There's so much on the screen, where to even begin? I think I want to start by creating a facility that turns lumber into planks. These two locations are already connected very short distance by a road, so we need but only create some trucks. Yes, that's right, trucks to cart the resources. I'm in the 1950s now, and that's one of the good things about free play. You don't have to start in 1850. You have three options, I believe, 1850, 1900, or 1950. Those are the big checkpoints. And we can see that represented here on the streets. All the pedestrians are updated. The car models, some of them are quite old for the 50s, yes. But still, they're cars, they're vehicles. They're working on buying some new stuff, some new rides. We've got like Beetles here and everything. It's a far cry from the horse and carriage, and I wanted to show you how the game looks closer to the modern era and all the vehicles that come with that territory. But if you weren't able to find two close-by facilities like these, how would you go about deciding where to begin? Down here at the information panel in the bottom left, you can actually pick to show a list of all the industries that are in this map and sort them. So I was looking for lumber. Actually, I think this is ore. I'm at the wrong place. That's my point, though, isn't it? Sort by product. Oh, yes. The tame forest. Exactly. Produces logs. That's what I want. Let's drag it over here so it stays marked on the screen, and I can just click, and it takes me over to that very facility where we were just looking moments ago, and there is its sister, the tame sawmill. You can find the tame sawmill by sorting by requirements instead. See? Just needs a little bit of lumber. And there it is, we found it on the list. So you can pair these off to easily find where you need to connect each building. Let's get started connecting and take a look at some of the new vehicles we have at our disposal. If I remember correctly, we'll need to go through the road tab and create a depot first and foremost, because without the depot, we're not going to be able to have any vehicles whatsoever. And I'd like to place the depot perhaps closer to the town. Because why build it adjacent to the lumber mill? What significance does that lumber mill really have for us? So let's build it close to some of the industries, because I feel like being thematic. We have industrial over here, a couple of poor saps and residential buildings in between those industrials. But I think this fits in perfectly in the industrial sector. That is what we're using this for. So let's get it as close to the road as we can without destroying any additional buildings. I'll give it a little breathing room in case that building ever decides to grow or upgrade. And there we go. Modern, well, 1950s modern, at least. Truck depot. What can we buy here for the road vehicles? Looks like we have three passenger and three freight. A Benz and an Opel Blitz. The Blitz is a bit more current, isn't it? 1935 to 1995. Wow. That is a very self-sustaining vehicle right there. Never gonna break down on you. But this one's a lot cheaper, isn't it? It's half the price. And we've only got 30 million, like I said. But what about the difference in carrying capacity? 8 versus 11. We'll make our money back quicker with 11. Almost 50% more so. But I kind of want to do one of each just to take a look at them. So I'm gonna buy you. And I'm gonna buy you. But most of the time, you should not buy a vehicle before you have a line set up. Otherwise, you're just paying maintenance for no reason. I'm not actually sure if maintenance accrues while they are in the depot or if it's just when they're running. It'd be nice if there was no maintenance while they were just sitting in the garage waiting for the right time to burst forth. But now that we got the depot, let's select freight. We don't want passengers, not yet. Cargo is what we're looking for. Large truck station with four large cargo terminals, or just a regular one with two. I don't think this is going to be a huge project. This is 33,000 versus 22. I want to go with the small one just to begin, because this seems like a small time project, doesn't it? Just a little bit of lumber. So let's turn this around so it's directly across from where we're going to be producing all that wood. And there we go. It's hooked up to the road, even if that connection is a little bit janky. Construction workers, next time, you know, pay a little bit more attention to that, please, if you'd be so kind. And we need one more truck station near where we're going to be taking all the goods. And here we are. Now, we don't want to build it up on the hill, do we? I wish the rotation keys. We're not N and M. I guess that's my fault for not changing the key bindings, but it is a bit awkward. Let's go down the hill a little ways so we can find a bit more friendly flat terrain. Does it cost more to build over that rock? I guess it does. Huh. Yeah, this isn't the best spot, admittedly, but we'll go for it. 25K. And with those two now able to be connected, we just need to create a line. So we're going to open the line manager tool here. Game's auto-saving and making me think my computer's crashing. And to create a new line, we just click here and it automatically toggles to add stations. So we just got to click on the two stations. So we want to start where the wood is coming from and end where the wood needs to be delivered, right? Makes perfect sense. Then we just have to put the two vehicles on that line. So let's click on them, and I believe we can just do it like this. There we go, wonderful. Get a little video in video feed of our new babies in action. Maybe we should buy even more. Maybe two trucks is not enough. That is kind of a long route, isn't it? Let's look at our handiwork. Truck number one, nice and blue. Looks like we got some active military personnel arriving in town. I wish that was like some kind of mod. You do boots on the ground, everybody under arrest. Look where the engine is stored under the hood there. I like the gold plating on the green, I gotta admit. But the one behind it looks a lot more modern, and it's right up on its tail, so I think it goes a lot faster, too. Aha, another reason to pick the newer model over the old. I really just wanted to see what it looked like, even the wheels. Look at those little hubcaps spinning around. It's so slow. You're getting tailgated right now. My pedal's on the floor. I can't go any faster, man. All right, let's make some more vehicles. We can actually retire the other one when it comes back around so it's not getting in the way and sell it. I just like to experiment with the different options that we have available. Top speed, 40 kilometers per hour versus 60. Yeah, 50% faster. Enough said, I think. Let's buy two more of these. Should I have changed the color first? I feel like I should have changed the color. Whatever, we're just gonna have a row of blue vehicles. We'll change the color of the next one, okay? How about that? You guys go on line one as well. And there they go. Our elite fighting force of wood-carrying trucks now on the way. And part of the fun of this game is learning how to optimize, figuring out how many trucks you want for this line. And does the expense of maintaining those trucks as they drive, is that covered by the money that you're going to be making back by delivering the wood where it needs to go? $1,500 in upkeep every so often. I'm going to tell this truck to go to the depot. You have been eliminated, my friend. It's been nice knowing you, but we got to let all the other blue trucks go at top speed. So let's sell this if we can. Get $62,000 back. So we just wasted like 60 grand. It's okay. I just wanted to see the truck model and admire it. I'm not here to min-max necessarily. Now, do we have logs? Maybe that was the issue. Maybe there were no logs to pick up yet. But we've got some now. And I guess that is how you know if you have enough trucks or not. If the output of this facility, producing wood, see, we have none for this extra truck. But this is only the third one. So I'm sure given some time that we'll catch up here. It's kind of hanging out and waiting. It managed to grab one log. But while they're gone, while they're driving off, this is going to continually refill. All right. What else can we do? I want to show you some more modern vehicles. We need to work on a train. A modern train. After prowling through the Industries tab, I found a few noteworthy stations that are relatively close to each other I think would be great for a starter train line. We have Ashby Wold's steel mill, which I've pinned over here to the right. It requires iron and coal, and it outputs steel and slag. And how are we going to get those resources? Well, nearby is the Ashby Wold's coal mine, which is built into this mountain. So we need to get a train line going from here down this hill, which is going to be very expensive, by the way, over to this terminal. but steel. How do we get the steel? Well, we need iron, and if we look a little bit over in this direction, we're gonna find the Stapleford iron mine. Again, I found those all from the industries tab, just looked at products and pinned these tabs over here to the right, and I can just zoom around and find exactly where they are without having to look manually. I think these are all relatively close. For reference, it goes triangle like this from here to here and here. All three of those need to be hooked up. Let's do it. I'm gonna open up the train menu, and I've selected the freight station that has a dead end. The train will turn around automatically. After a lot of searching for a proper location, option A is here, basically. Like 103,000 is the cheapest it gets, or here. I like the way this looks a little bit better, but the track is gonna be much more difficult to build because it's a much steeper incline. So let's look for the cheapest I can find here. How much of a penny pincher am I gonna be? I see 105. I know I saw 103 earlier. Going once, going twice, and sold for $105,000. Yeah, this is looking a little bit better than the decline I was gonna see on the other side. Trying to go over the trees is what's gonna be so tough. But we have to hook this up to the road as well. Very important that we do so, and I'm not sure what kind of road they like to default to. I guess I'll just click around a little bit and see. That looks similar. Small street, two-lane road. Okay, I'm down with that for $14,000, even if it comes off of this awkward country road. I guess I'll just have to get used to that. Kind of difficult to get used to, though. All right, there is one station. Now, how are we going to get the track going where we need it to go? Standard or high speed? Ooh, new types of tracks. And new buttons. Path signals, used as a normal path signal to regulate traffic or as a one-way signal, and waypoints, used for rerouting a line. Add it to a line like a station. And then we have upgrades for electrification and extra high-speed tracks. Okay. That is a little bit beyond my pay grade right now. I'm gonna focus on standard tracks with limited speed. As we build the track here, I'm trying to find a nice, that's a big bridge. Absolutely unnecessary. Let's kind of pause it right there. You might notice that there are cables and wires. These are called catenary. I guess that's a pronunciation. And it's just electrified track. So you're gonna need these for electric trains that don't run off of another type of fuel. I'm not sure if we need them for the train that we're gonna be making, but it seems like a future-proofing to some degree, and look, this is as low as we can get the track. So if we don't do this right, it is going to be mandatorily a bridge, unfortunately. So check this out. Look at what I am weaseling into here. We're gonna follow the course of the mountain all the way down. This reminds me so much of playing games like City Skylines and Sim City, because you had to do just that to tweak the terrain just the right way so that it approved of the direction that you took. I'm guessing the train is gonna have some dramatic slowdown when going around that curve, but ultimately what it means is that we don't have to pay for a $1 million bridge. And I think that alone is well worth it. And we're coming through another hill here, which is looking pretty fine. $30,000 a track. We're spending a lot of money, but we still got $28 million. Now, here's the question. Where should our next station be? I'm skipping ahead in the interest of saving you the same headache that I just went through. We've still got the amazing mountain pass for our train tracks, but I had to make a huge curve to the left. And a man-made hill was formed. It was a little expensive, but it's okay. The reason is because I had to move the train station. It seems like it's off in the middle of nowhere. I know it does. But here's what happened, right? See how this road has this big steep decline right here? Yes, I know it needs to be connected to the street game. Thank you. I've not started yet. The track was formerly on a steep this tall, and the track could not make the gap, because look, we're on an incline. The hill goes all the way down, and this is about as high as the train track can go, so trying to go up that extra lip was impossible. So by making this horizontal across the hill from left to right, this is completely flat, and that means that the train track is going to have no problem hooking up here. It'll might have a little problem getting up the hill, but I digress. We've got a new train station over here. Also needs to be connected to a road. We're gonna work on that. And I've started creating the track. It's crossed one road so far, and we're getting ready to cross another. We need to hook it up to the station up here where my mouse is. So we're gonna go directly straight across, up the hill, curve right, and connect. That is the plan. Let's see if we can make it happen for the least amount of money possible. Notice how we're starting to dip down. I want to raise this up kind of as much as I can to get us on the high ground as we begin the climb up this little hill, which seems like it shouldn't be that difficult, but it's more daunting of a task than maybe it initially appears. Look, it wants to make a tunnel. Do you see my point now? Do you see why this was a problem before? I now have to snake my way up the hill. So I'll probably need to go left around the trees. Oh boy. Okay. Let's go left for $23,000. I feel like I'm on a game show right now for $23,000. But if we snake right, see, it's not doing the tunnel thing anymore, but it is pushing the hill even further back. Look at all of that white checker for 500 grand. We are a little bit too deep into the mountain, and no amount of hitting N or M at this point is going to save us. You like my snake rail? It was the only way. If there was another way, I don't know what it would be. Turns out this is an awful place to have a train station. Today I learned, but that's kind of the fun of the game, is learning the systems and how the rails are to be built properly, so you can plan ahead in the future. Like, maybe it would have just been smarter to drag the line from here and make a bridge going down, or go through the mountain for millions of dollars to connect it up to somewhere else, or hit up some other station somewhere through this side. But when you're creating a new map, you can affect how hilly the terrain is. So there's like small, medium, and large, basically, and this is the medium size. So let's hook up our roads and see this train in action after all this time that we have been waiting. Before we do the honors and buy a new train to play with our completed line, there's something that's probably been standing out to many of you like a sore thumb. Etalyx, why is there a passenger terminal here, where there should be a cargo terminal? And then I say, I don't know. So let's delete that and pretend it never happened. If you're on the wrong tab, you might have a bad time and your line might be useless. Here's the good news. Like a puzzle piece, this snaps right back in. Waste of money, yes, but it's less money than we would have wasted if I had tried to get this train to operate and carry resources to the wrong station. We don't have any passengers here in the middle of nowhere. Fortunately, I guess, for us, because it would be kind of awkward if there were. Now let's buy the train. Let's take a look over here at the old depot. See what she has to offer for us. There are so many more compared to the Wild West, where there are only like two or three. Let's just do locomotives. Looks like they're all in order of build date. 1902, 14, 1921, 1925, 27, 35, all the way up to the brand new Nohab AA 16 from 1954, freshly unlocked. Yeah, it's 55, but oh well. So this baby is diesel powered. Diesel electric, interesting. Don't know if it uses the electrified rails or not, but I know that all the ones with the little dongle on top definitely do. So if you didn't have those, I guess this is the last steam engine. Fastest steam locomotive. We don't need you. What we need is something that can carry cargo. I love looking at all these. I wish we could buy each one and just observe them. Class E94, 1938. A little bit old, but it ran all the way till 95. So pretty reliable and sturdy. This is a heavy freight locomotive. $7.5 million later, I'm buying it. What color should it be, though? First, neon green, obviously. Is that even a question? Much improved over that dark green. Now for wagons. We have some passenger cars on the top. This is going to carry our coal, iron, and slag that we're going to be producing. Tanks for oil. And then finally, state car for finished products like steel, logs, and such. So if we wanted to carry the logs that we're making elsewhere on the map, this is how we would do it. I think we're going to buy just a bunch of open wagons. Should we just have the neon green train, or should we make it multicolored? Neon green. Just all of them. The whole thing. How many cars do we want? I want to do six. Six sounds excessive, and it may well be, but I want this train to look cool. So a couple million dollars later, we're down to 17 and a half mil. It's already been attached for us. You can see it here. We could move cars around if we had different setups that we wanted. Now we just need to make a line. Let's do that. The icing on this cake. I am so looking forward to it. Brand new line. Neon green. Very fitting. Station one. Station two. And station three. There might be a better way to set this up in the future, but I want to run the line at least once just to find out if it works. Line number three, here she comes out the open gate. Ooh, look at that shiny, glossy paint job. It almost is camouflaged on the grassy surroundings. And off she goes. Let's speed this up a little bit and follow train one along for the ride. I feel like you have to almost shield your eyes. If you saw this in a reflection, it might hurt a little bit. Hey, the train went to the correct station. And look, six cars. Just looks amazing, doesn't it? We gotta pick up any cargo? Is there anything here to pick up? I guess is a better... No production. Uh-oh. Did I do something else wrong? Here's the good news. I'm not crazy, and they are producing iron. You can see it here. We're about to load up with what we can carry. But I have made a mistake with my line. I do need to add our middle stop twice. How much of this can we carry? I'm also crazy because we have too many train cars right now. These little facilities simply cannot produce enough to fill six cargo loads worth of iron or coal, respectively. Coal currently only has 12 waiting for us. It just took a while for them to warm up with production to get started, I guess. So here's what we're gonna have to do, right? We're gonna have to change the line around and add an extra stop here at Ashby Woods. That way we'll stop at it twice and make money twice. But I'm also gonna have to send this train back to the depot because it's costing us a ton of money in maintenance fees every so often. Let's watch the route because this is my favorite part. And here in a moment, you'll be able to see why it's so expensive. It'll tick for like $125,000, down to $15 million. I've already spent like $1 million or $2 million in maintenance fees, and we don't make enough money back to pay for it. And yes, the train does slow down a little bit when going around the curves, which I think is kind of cool. That is an awful track. I know, I'm ashamed of it, but what can you do? So here is our first giant delivery, $524,000. I mean, that's money. That's big money, right? But look, another 122 just seeped out. And now we're producing a whole bunch of steel, but we don't have anywhere to take it. So when this hits 100, we're kind of gonna be done. And that's why you have to keep playing. We have to cart the steel off to some other facility that requires it and offload what we've got here. And I know I just removed the best thing about the whole track. I'm sorry, let's slow this down and admire the view, shall we? Coming down. Ooh, the mountain pass. So sexy. Don't freeze frame autosave. How dare you interrupt my view of pleasure. Oh no, and this is where the production aspect comes into play here. We've got too much coal. They don't have any more use for it. They don't need any more coal. We have to find somewhere else to take it instead. Who else needs coal? I don't know, but that's the fun of Transport Fever. Managing your lines and figuring out how to deal with these escalating situations. Go back to the depot. You're gonna have to just dump all the... Nope, not reverse. Wrong button. Go to depot. Yeah, figuring out how to make money and stop losing money. So important. Our trucks still having a heyday down here. I think we're about to deposit a little bit extra. I want to see how much money these trucks made. We never really did take a close look at that, did we? Pulling into the station now, supplementing our income with $3,000, and that's it. Why $3,000? Well, I don't know. Maybe we just didn't have that many resources in the back of that truck's bed. I think lumber is making a lot more, which should be on the other side of the map. How much are you giving us? $2,000 in maintenance. Got another truck rolling up now. 0 of 11 logs. Uh-oh. Do we have one too many trucks here? We may well do. Production is at zero. Is that because we're full of logs here? Have I done the thing that I said earlier? I don't see anything being made. I'm actually kind of confused about this because we definitely watch them pick up and deliver. I don't know if it's a bug or if I'm stupid. I'm going to assume that I'm stupid, but I'm going to try to figure all this out and we're going to stream the game here the next couple of days. Just wanted to give you a little preview of Freeplay. And let you know how the game looks when you have a little bit more freedom, open-ended aspects to maintaining and running and starting your business, getting it going off the ground. Thank you all so much for watching these videos. I'm gonna work on solving all these problems now, and I'll see you next time.